the video. Ready. When you hit unpause, you just go. That's your request. I requested 1 minute. So you are the slowest, so they will go at your 1 minute. This is the Bastion scenario, as just recently released, and I'm playing against Miguel Molina, the old fox. He's the one that's been writing all those after-action reports on Punta de Lanza forum, and we finally got together for a multiplayer battle. He thought that this was an interesting situation, so we've selected this scenario to cut his teeth on the multiplayer aspect. We've just reviewed the scenario background and my current orders. There's a minefield out there, and a suspected location of a ballistic nuclear submarine patrol zone. I've just crossed into the ice zone, and I've set my sonar for intermittent active and passive, traveling at a rate of 12 knots. I'm hoping that I will still be able to detect any potential mines before I actually hit them. This is a slight problem, or limitation, not a problem, of ANW. In Harpoon 3, we have many different types of sonar. Some of these are very short-range, high-frequency anti-mine or mine detection sonar. Problem is, you can't just turn on one sonar. When you go active, all your sonar goes active. And in order to activate the mine avoidance sonar, you have to activate the more powerful sonar that reveal you to a longer distance. So I think I've just revealed myself to my enemy, but I can't help it. Either that, or I run blindly into a minefield. In Harpoon 3, mines do not work. The mines that we have created are... Oh, there's our first sonar contact. Mines are a simulated weapon. The actual mine weapons do not work, and we do the best we can with these. We make them as submarines that fire explosives. This is the best we can do. So they're not perfect, but it kind of suits our purpose. Yes. The first contact has been detected, and I'm turning off my sonar. I'm going to try to draw a course perpendicular to him in order to possibly generate a cross bearing or a cross fixed to his location. It's very vague, but I fear submarines more than I fear mines at this time. Although I have not been able to pinpoint the enemy submarine, I have his blade count. This is the number of revolutions that the sonar operator can hear to determine the speed of an enemy contact. He is making 5 knots. This is most likely not a mine, and is most likely, I can consider this a probable hostile enemy submarine. So I will classify it with the H hotkey as hostile. Moving it, he's in motion at 5 knots. A mine would not be in motion. So I will treat him as hostile. I will also reduce speed slightly and make sure that I am diving to a maximum depth. I am at the SSN San Juan class, or 688 improved San Juan class, is probably one of the most advanced submarines in the Navy, so I feel we can probably go a little bit faster and still retain our stealth. He most likely heard my presence with the active sonar. Nothing I can do about that now. I will try to creep upon him, but he could be hiding behind a minefield here, trying to draw me into it, so I have to remain cautious. At some point, I may have to go active again, else I run the risk of hitting a mine. I have picked up, I'm confirmed, he's moving at 26 knots. This guy is running hot. Definitely hostile, but outside the range of my torpedoes, but not for long. Let's plot an intercept course. Well, if he is here, I'm going to mark his position. I will also mark what I think his course is and where it's coming from. I will mark this as a ship detection zone. The reason I'm marking this is I think that if he's coming out of this area at this high speed, he is unlikely to have run right through a minefield. So probably this is a safe route into his bastion, or the area from which he came. And that would make it a good point, a good area, or a good ingress path to investigate. Well, I've supposedly lost contact with him. And me, amazing. You see him right this, in a small zone, in perfect location, and then all of a sudden you get this monstrous, ridiculously, now how the hell do you go from a perfectly located to an uncertainty zone the size of New Jersey? Ridiculous. Anyway, that's the way Harpoon works. What I think should be is if you lose contact, if you have perfectly located, then you lose contact, the uncertainty zone gets larger and larger and larger, which is what most things happen, but not in ANW. You go from perfect to somewhere within a million kajillion square miles. I'm tracking the enemy submarine. He's moving at 26 knots from this point, so this is probably a pretty safe route to follow behind him. I wish I could speed up, but I'm not in any rush to get killed. So I will move in on his route and then try to shadow him. The game is quite unresponsive at this time. It's very slow to take the orders because there are so many mines and so many active sonar working in here. Even though there's only a few submarine opponents, the mines each have their own sonar, and they're trying to detect the submarines, the controlled by the players. The server crashed, and we've restarted at a save game point. My opponent has decided to change tactics after restarting the game. Instead of running back, he has decided to come out and challenge me. His maneuvers have shown that he is an Akula 1 improved class Russian submarine. This is a very tough opponent, and he, at this range, he's creeping along at 5 knots, so I'll match his creep. I don't know if he's counter-detected me yet, but I've got to be careful about that. He is almost as quiet as I am. This happens when you get a crash and your opponent doesn't do what he did before. That's part of life. He got some free intel and he didn't have to pay for it, which is unfortunate for my side, but this is A&W, where crashes happen. He's changed course and is heading towards me. This means he's probably detected me. We're on a collision course, and he is going to be within range fairly soon. We're checking the range. Number pad 5 turns on the range finder, and he's at 10.5 miles. He's just outside my maximum range. It's approximately 6 or 7. Because the second I fire, I expect him to turn off like a bat out of hell and run. So I'm going to need the maximum range for my torpedoes. Now here's a crappy situation. As I close in to engage my target, I've seemingly lost contact with him. I don't know what the sonar conditions are or why this is happening, but this is going to be problematic. He's getting within theoretical firing range. And as am I. He's probably detected me, and he's lurking for a shot. This guy's fast, 35 knots maximum. So if I engage him from maximum range, he is very likely able to outrun my torpedoes. We're talking even the 48 knot ad cap can be outrun if you immediately turn around and run the opposite direction. This is allowed in Harpoon, even though it's much more difficult in real life. I think I'm going to have to take my shot now. He's slowing down to 1 second compression, and that usually means something bad is going to happen. He might even have gone up to above the layer in order to fire an SSN surf 16 Starfish or other rocket delivered torpedo. They have much greater range, and he has them, I do not. So I'm going to gamble, and I'm going to be firing I'm going to fire a full spread of torpedoes on bearing only launch. As soon as the torpedoes leave the tubes, I intend to run in another direction at best possible speed. This is to throw off his efforts. He's going to detect the torpedoes. His sonar is good. So I am going to activate one of my ADCAP sonar, and I'm going to put it on full speed right away. The other torpedoes I'm going to spread out just a little bit, but they should be able to still catch that guy. Let's see if my tactic works. picked them up, moving at 26 knots. This is slower than I thought he'd be moving. Maybe he's up. Oh, he's still driving in. He's rushing to his doom, thank goodness. Bless his heart. I have accelerated two torpedoes to run at full speed, 65 knots. I thought I had. I guess I had not. There we have now. Soon they will pick him up and send him to the bottom. Do you hear the sound of your death approaching? I like a man who can hum as he watches death approach. Smoke a last cigarette. Have a last sip of that Coke. Like a little mouse, he runs one way or then the other, but the cat has him. Explosion detected. Breakup noises. One dead Russian sub. After catching his submarine and killing it, I've plotted his last two points of contact, where he was and where he think is. So I'm going to head in on those last two points and then move towards the last reported position of the Bastion. These are the last two safe points I know where he was running, so I can move at fairly high speed towards them. Once there, I'll slow down again and have to creep in towards the patrol zone, simply because I don't know if there are any submarines or mines in between here and that point. This could be an entire minefield I'm running into. Intelligence has been known to be wrong. Intelligence, the department where we bet your life. Oh, and one more. It's nice to have a multiplayer session, and Miguel was kind enough to confirm. We did, as he was coming in, and we lost contact with him approximately here. When his contact grew vague, it was because he had gone up to the shallow depth. So he did a very good tactic there that only a human could have done. An AI would not have done so. So he almost lost me. If only he knew just how close he came to forcing me to lose contact. Good job, Miguel. Here's my first submarine contact off to the side. It's at 50 meters and making 5 knots. This must be a second submarine and possibly the boomer. I've decided I'm going to send my next 4 torpedoes after him. There he goes. As before, we move to evade. I will activate one torpedo to full speed and active sonar. and a second torpedo. The enemy has increased speed and is heading towards me. I have also increased speed to full in order to evade. This by increasing speed, I am causing problems for his targeting. In Harpoon, the speed difference between the target and the firing unit determines at what range a weapon can be fired. The faster the target is going, me, the closer the firing unit must be. Therefore, by increasing to full speed, I am forcing him to get within maybe 5 or 6 miles before weapons will release for him. Is that it? A la derecha, a la izquierda, gol! Yes. Ooh, okay. Yes. The submarines have been destroyed, and Miguel has resigned from the game. We could just run it right out, but I think that we'll just resign the same way. We've destroyed the SSBN, and we protected ours from completion. I could wait for 23 hours more, but there's no way he's going to sink me, so we just decided to call the game rather than run out the clock to the end. We'll examine all the losses, and we did kill the Acula and a Typhoon. He used a great number of decoys. It was nice to confirm with Miguel. His comments at the end of the scenario were he was just about to fire his VA-211, I think, Shkval. These are the rocket torpedoes that have a 200 knot speed. He said I was at approximately 4.5 mile range, and he was going to let me have it, as well as a pair of USN 80s. However, the server crashed, so he lost his firing solution when we had to restart. So in one way, the first crash was good for him. In the second way, the crash was good for me. But thank you again, Miguel Molina, for a very challenging little scenario and being a good sport and good opponent. This concludes The Bastion, written for Harpoon 3 and the Player's Database.